In this video, I'm going to introduce you to a very powerful function in Google Sheets, which is the filter function. With this function, you get to return multiple match results. So not just the first match, but all the matches. And because you're filtering your data with a function, your results are going to update automatically. You can filter based on one or multiple columns, and I'm going to show you how you can get your filter data sorted in ascending or descending order in Google Sheets. This video is a part of my Google Sheets comprehensive online course. It has everything you need to master Sheets. It takes you from beginner all the way to Google Sheets expert. Link to it is in the description of the video. Now let's get to the filter function. Here I have some information on different apps by region, by division, and I'm collecting the sales and the profit information. The current data set goes up to line 58. What I want to do is get the apps, sales, and profit by region. So I want to add a dropdown for region here, and the moment I update my selection, I want to get that list automatically populated in here. Because I have multiple matches for each region, I'm going to use the filter function here. But first, let's add our dropdown. Right mouse click, go to data validation. I want my list from a range. That range is my region range here, but I'm just going to leave it open-ended. So in case I add more data to this or I have different regions, it's automatically going to populate in my dropdown. I also want to reject the input so that I accept only values from my list, from my selection, click on save. So let's go and select Europe for now. Now we're going to start off with our filter function. One thing you need to know is that the filter function spills. So we don't have to worry about the dollar signs when we do our range references. We just need to write one formula, press enter, and we're going to get all results back. It's really easy to use. What does it need? First requirement is the range. This is the range that we want to get back. So in this case, I want to get app, sales, and profit back. So I have to select these three columns. You can select a single column, more than three columns. Whatever you want to get back, that's what you need to select. But you can only select one range. So in this case, I just want these three back. I'm going to leave this open-ended. So in case I add more data, they will automatically be considered. Next is the condition. Take a look at the example here. The condition is a logical test. It's checking whether the values in this range is greater than 5. Now here's something important about the filter function. Ultimately, this function only includes true values. So basically, whenever this value in this range is greater than 5, it's going to result in a true and it's going to include that. If it doesn't, it's going to result in a false and it's going to ignore that. Right? So that's the engine behind this. Only true values are included. In this case, my logical test is for region. I want to test whether these regions here, I'm going to leave it open-ended as well, whether these are equal to this. That's the only condition I have. So one thing you need to make sure of is that your ranges are identical in height because you need to be consistent between the two data sets. This all looks good. I'm going to close bracket, press enter, and that's my result. Now I've also added a formula here so that it's easier for you to read the formula. It just uses the formula text function. So now, if I switch my view to Australia, I get the apps for Australia. South America, I get the South American apps. Now, what if we want to add more conditions? So let's say we want to update this function to include sales values greater than 0. So I don't want to show these zeros here, only include results that are greater than 0. This means I have another condition. And with the filter function here, it's really easy to add more conditions because check this out, we get the ability to add a second condition or even more conditions. Our second condition in this case is that the sales values here, so from the sales column, are greater than 0. So let's make sure we're consistent. Now I'm going to go with greater than zero. Now in case you might have negative numbers in a column and you want it to do does not equal to a number, you need to use this sign. So less than and greater than sign. In this case, we just want greater than zero. That's it, press enter, and the zeros are also filtered out. Now let's go ahead and sort the results by profit in ascending order. Okay, so we're gonna put this inside the sort function because we wanna sort this result. Now let's go to the end here and press F1 to bring back the help. For sort, after we define our range, we need to define the sort column. In this case, what's my sort column? It's number 3, right? Because profit is the third column. Then we need to define if we want it in ascending or descending order. I want ascending, so I'm gonna go with true, close bracket, press enter, and I have my results sorted by profit in ascending order. I can switch and everything updates automatically. Now let's just double check what happens when we add more information to this. What if we add information from a new region? Let's just copy this part of the data set. I'm gonna paste it here. And let's add New Zealand. So let's say we decide to add New Zealand as a separate region here. And let's also add a brand new app to an existing region. I'll call this Health Hacks and enter. So do these show up automatically in here? I added a new region, New Zealand. My information is there. It's sorted by a profit. And I added a new app to Asia, Health Hacks, and it's right here. Notice that the filter function doesn't have any problems with duplicate numbers either. Now, if you're using Excel 365, you have to be aware that there is a difference between the function signature of the filter function for Google Sheets versus Excel. The first two requirements are identical between the applications. In Excel, the third argument is the if-empty argument, basically what we want returned if no matches are found. And in Google Sheets, you can use the third argument and actually more arguments after that to add additional criteria. In Excel, there is a different way of doing this. Now, if you're curious, I have a separate video on the filter function for Excel. Link to it is below. That's it for today. If you're new here and haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do that before you leave, and I'm gonna see you in the next video.